Hi, my name is Kairav. I'm a member of the Teen Advisory Board with the Howard County Library System. And in this video, I'm going to show you all how to build with Legos online. Just to clarify, this is part one, and there will also be a part two for this tutorial. In this video, I'll be going over how to find pieces, how to change their color, and how to move them. For the best experience, I would recommend using a computer with a mouse, because without a mouse, you might find it difficult to navigate around the site. Do not use a phone, as it will be very hard to see and use most of the tools on there. So the site we're going to be using, as you can see, is Mecabricks.com. This site does not require any money, downloads, or an account in order to use most of the things here. So once you get there, you should see the screen. You should also see a green button that says Start Now. Right here, go ahead and click that. And once you do that, it should take you to the workshop where you can start building everything. And you'll see this pop up asking first time on Mecabricks. So let me explain what all these are. So the first button, start, takes you to another page and provides most of the basics on how to use this workshop with some steps listed. In other words, a very brief introduction on how you can begin. So as you can see, this page shows you all the 10 steps with screenshots provided. So next is shortcuts, which lists every shortcut that you can use on your keyboard in this workspace. Third, we have Snap, which takes you to a YouTube video from a demonstration on how to use the Snap tool. This video shows an efficient way on how to connect some of the pieces that you want to use. And then finally, render is basically a way that you can make some of your models look realistic using an add-on Blender, which is used mainly for animation. Although a download is required, Blender is actually free to use. Okay, let's go back to our workshop. I'm going to go ahead and close this for now, but if you want to open it up again, just click the help button right here and this will reappear. Anyways, right here we got a nice looking grid, our x-axis being this red line and our y-axis being this blue line. Now at the bottom you can see we have some Lego bricks we can choose from, and each brick has a unique number or ID. So let's click on this 1x4 brick right here. We can change the color if we want by clicking on this and then going over to all these colors right under materials. I'm going to choose red. And then you can also choose the color before you display the block. So I'm going to delete this. Then I'm going to go ahead and choose color. Let me pick green. Then let me spawn this 1x6 piece right here, and there you go, it's a green brick. You can also change like the type of material in general. So there's rubber and then transparent, metal, and chrome, all sorts of things and designs. So the plus sign right here represents the different types of designs that can be used with this exact same piece. Notice how the ID is same, but there's a letter and then a number right after that. All right, let's go back. So to do that, just click this arrow that's pointing upward. And there are actually multiple other parts you can use besides these bricks. So you can use these Lego animals and then tires and then wheel parts. If you want to learn a little more about each piece, you can just go to the top where it says parts and then you can click on piece. So this two right here represents the version. And then these blue and red arrows, like, they represent the pivot points and whether They can be extended along the X or Y axis. So we can hide the grid view by clicking this. We can extend it. And then we can see a little bit more about the data of this brick. And as you can see, it's rendered and is a version 2, just like I said. Go back to the rest of the bricks, just click this folder right here. And then if you want to see more specific things, then just click on the person right there and you'll see like it explains the pivot points as well as the number of designs this brick has and whether it has another unique ID. And then this also explains like whether it can be used in LEGO Digital Designer or LEGO Draw, which are two other LEGO designing websites that you can use. So let's go back. Now to move a piece, simply click on piece. So you'll see three arrows, a red, a blue, and a green. The red represents moving it left and right. Blue represents moving it forward and backward, and green is up and down. And you're not actually limited to just this graph space. Notice how I move it and the graph extends in both directions. And it will usually shrink unless you have another piece. So right here, like this will extend it. And then you can extend it right here. But since this piece is there, like it will not like come back to its original unless like you move it back. And then you'll also notice that each object has these small squares right here. This represents like whether they can be extended on the x-axis or the y-axis. So this can only be extended through the x-axis. But here you can see it can be extended by the y-axis. Now, to rotate the piece, the easiest way would be to use the arrow keys, right for clockwise, left for counterclockwise, up for moving it forward, and then down for moving it backward. And then you can also go to transform if you want to like edit where you want it to be at a specific location. So if I wanted to be back at the origin, then I could set all of this to be 0. But if I wanted like leaning a little more forward, then I could set the X to be 10. And then the rest of these at 0. So there you go. And then you could also use move where you could actually move this to the right by setting it to the x-axis. And then let's use number like 50 and you'll see move to the right. And to move it left, keep it on the x-axis and just use a negative number, any negative number, like say 20, and move it forward and backward, you would use the Z, not the Y, and let's use a number like 80, and backward, negative number, and going up and down, you would use the Y axis, so let's use number like 100, not 1000. Okay, let's bring it down. So negative number, and this can also be rotated. So if you want to rotate, say 45 degrees, then do that. Or we could do a 180. This will flip it upside down if you do it by the x-axis. So this is everything you need to know for part 1. I hope all of you found this part of the tutorial to be useful.